Yo, Jeff Coga here. Welcome to the month end review of the Jeff Coga Live YouTube channel. And figure I'd make this video as I'm recording this on February 3rd to give you an update on what's been happening with this particular channel. So that way you guys and gals can see kind of the analytics of a YouTube channel and viewership and what I guess an internet marketer can do to grow their YouTube channel, or someone who's in business or want to make money online and things like that. So I figure I talk about it. Now, a couple disclaimer, as I do on all these YouTube channel, I am a seasoned professional internet marketer, as well as I have other income streams outside of YouTube. And the main goal of this particular channel is to generate, or it was the main goal, was to generate income from quote unquote YouTube's money, or based on viewership. Okay. Now, I do have some good news and I have some bad news depending on which side of the spectrum you're on. And let's start with the bad news first, because I got this email not too long ago. Let me see the actual date here. January 16th from YouTube. And it actually says, important update to the YouTube Partner Program. Ooh, and if you don't know what a YouTube Partner Program is, it's basically how majority, how people get like, oh my gosh, these people that make YouTube videos, this is how you make money on YouTube. When people watch it, I get paid money, right? So I get a notice from them. And if you're not aware, I'm a firm believer that if you're going to make money from YouTube, you should make money not from YouTube, but something else, and use YouTube's platform to generate viewership and eyeballs. Now, I do communicate with over 300,000 people on my email list, but I have not sent them a link to my YouTube channel. Right, I have not. Nor do I push anyone from my other social media channel to my YouTube page. And the reason being I don't do that is because I think someone that's just starting off to try to grow their YouTube channel for the purposes of creating a personal brand, or using it for business, probably will not have the assets that I have. So I figure, you know what, let me create this and document this journey on YouTube without using any of this stuff. So when I got this, I was just like, oh my gosh. So what is this? Okay, YouTube Partner Program is that income based on viewership. And it says here, what's changing under the new eligibility requirement announced today, your YouTube channel, Jeff Coga's channel, is no longer eligible for monetization. Dun, 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 dun. And because it doesn't meet the new threshold of 4,000 hours watch time within the past 12 months, I'm sorry, and 1,000 subscribers. Okay. And as a result, your channel will lose all access to monetization tools and features associated with YouTube Partner Program on February 20th, 2018, unless you surpass the threshold in the next 30 days. Accordingly, this email serves as a 30-day notice to your YouTube Partner Program, and terms are terminated. Ooh, that's a kind of a stinger. And clearly, I do not meet those metrics, because let me show you the analytics of what's happening here. And if we go to the analytics of my page, let's go ahead and go to overview section. And let me make this a little bit smaller so you guys and gals can see. Let's see here. Here's the analytics of my particular page. And let me actually shrink this down a little bit so you guys and gals can see this. Is if I go lifetime of this, as I've started recording this journey now since April of this year, is you'll see this, okay? Lifetime, okay? 61 minutes listened to, and viewers like 18,000. And if you're interested in how I've been doing every single month, here's an actual screenshot of a spreadsheet I created. It should be in the description section, where you can see kind of the growth, or the snail pace growth, let's be honest, and the amount of subscribers and amount of videos I'm releasing and things like that. So bottom line is that clearly I'm going to lose privilege to the YouTube income. Now, one of the things that I'm going to lose income to is this amount of money, okay? This amount of money. Let me show you what I'm talking about here, okay? If I click on this section, the revenue report, this is the YouTube Partner Program. And you can see, oh my gosh, I lose revenue to a whopping $9.57 that I've earned on my lifetime of being on YouTube. And you can clearly see that's rich. I'm rich, ladies and gentlemen. But you can see, if you have to live off that, that is way under poverty level here in the United States, I think. How do you live off that, right? I can probably make more money just standing on a busy freeway and just asking for change probably, okay? But you can clearly see that this is a problem, okay? This is a problem. So again, that's the bad news for me, that when I saw this, and then I started asking the question, what's the counter perspective? What's the good news? All right. And that's an exercise I do a lot when it comes to this kind of stuff, because look, in business and life, right, it's never a linear line. It never goes straight. So when I saw this, hey, you know, what's the good news? The good news is this, is that a lot of people that is looking to get into YouTube for the sheer sake of making money, they're going to be like, oh my gosh, I don't want to do this, because you can't even get this, right? So now if you're starting a channel, you have to be a really, really strategic in being able to at least hit these metrics so they can give you some, make some money. So as the old saying on my trainings and everything else that I talk about outside of just YouTube, I always tell people, I say, hey, you know, you never want to have all of your eggs in one basket, okay, in terms of controlling the viewership. So I tell people, get them on your email list, right? Because if you can get them on their email list, then guess what? Even if YouTube makes these changes, you can always drive traffic, okay? So like, for example, for me, this is not my first YouTube channel. I have other channels that I have tons and tons of views on, and other ones that I have, you know, tens and 20, 30, 40, 50,000 views, and other ones that I have a couple thousand more subscribers, because currently right now, my subscribership is what? I have let's take a look at 119 subscribers, okay? And I appreciate each and every one of you. If you watched this so far and you've gotten this far, I thank you from the bottom of my heart that you've been, you know, kind of following this journey, especially for the folks that's been watching and you're part of the 18,638 total views I got. Thank you. Especially if you've seen multiple videos of mine, thank you so much for that, okay? But it's really difficult if this is what you have to live by, right? Like $10. How do you live off $10? You just simply cannot. So you want to take your audience and put them on an email list, okay? You absolutely want to put them on an email list, and it's something that I want to make sure that you guys and gals are aware of, because if like this happens on whatever platform you're on, you have the ability to market. Now, moving forward, I have a decision to make. Do I use my assets and actually let people know? Because I thought about this. I said, hey, before February 20th, should I just email my list and then boom, get all of that views? I could. If I just one click of a button, I can probably do that. And just so that way you know that I'm not kidding, let me show you something, okay? All right, so here, there's an account with one of my email accounts. It's by Infusionsoft. And you see here, 100,000 contacts. This is one of them, okay? Here's another one. I have 260,000 contacts in this one. And I have another one that has 185,000 contacts in these, right? So as you can imagine, if you add these up, I have way more than 300,000 contacts. And if I send out an email, yes, absolutely, I can go ahead and get tons and tons of traffic and subscribers to it. But look, listen, I don't want to do that, because I know folks, if you're watching this and you've been following along and you're just getting started or you're looking to build a brand, you don't have that. So what I'm going to do is the complete opposite and just kind of grind it out and do what other people have the ability to do, which boils down to the next thing I want to talk about is AdWords, right? AdWords is a platform through Google, and Google owns YouTube, where you can drive traffic. So what I've been doing heavily on is just simply running retargeting ads. So meaning that if you watched any of my videos, then I just literally run other ads to my other videos like this, right? You can see this, you can see this, you can see this, right? And I'm running. And so I'm going to continuously do that. And the budget that I have for this is something that most individuals should have. If not, you can at least scrap, sell some stuff and put it together, which is about $100 that I'm using. So all in all, if you add all of my money of YouTube I've spent, is about $898. So this $254 originally spent it back when I first did this, I was doing some other testing and I was just like, you know what? When I started, I was like, most people can't drop that like in a month. So let me go ahead and start with just simply $2 a day. And then now I've gone up to $100, right? So I'm going to leave it at $100. And then now all I'm going to do is change some of the strategies when it comes to running AdWords. And I'm going to bring in probably new viewership and kind of divide my ad spend from kind of probably $30 to retargeting and $60 for new traffic, since YouTube is not allowing me to get revenue. So now if I have to physically make an income from just strictly YouTube, then I know I have to make some money some way out, some other shape or form. So I'm going to put together a game plan to start generating some income. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to default and do something that that I have experience in and is probably, which is a wide product I can create, is something like a financial product in terms of financial literacy. Talk about investing, talk about how to get out of debt, talk about how to pay down your debt, right? Understanding interest. And matter of fact, talk about a way to get like 20% return on your money, 25% return on your money by simply understanding how it works. Okay. And so I'm going to start doing that and changing my strategy up. So again, if you're listening to this and you've gotten this far, and I know you did, if you've gotten this far, is that you know the importance of moving, you know the importance of change, you know the importance of doing something different. So that's what I'm going to do. And hopefully you can follow along and continue to follow along on this journey as you witness how I grow this particular YouTube channel. And as it stands, look, if this is my only stream of income, I would probably like give up, right? Like really, like if you think about it, it's kind of like, whoa, man, I got to give up on this, right? But I don't want to do that. So I'm going to pivot and change and figure out some other ways to do this. And you have to do that not only just in business and making money, but in life, okay? So that's kind of my message for today for y'all who's been following along. And if you haven't done already, please do me a huge favor. Go to my channel and hit the subscribe button so I can get up from 119 subscribers and we can continue to grow this particular channel. And hopefully you can learn a thing or two. And if you did, let me know in the comment box. This is your boy, Jeff Coga. Love y'all. Stay out there. Do more, be more, and continuously grow more. So thank you so much. Love y'all. Take care and bye-bye.